Hey everyone, and thanks for watching 3dmotive.com. In this week's tips and tricks video, what I'm going to be covering is how to characterize your character inside of MotionBuilder and prepare it for the input of motion capture data to drive the skeleton. So basically what I have here is I have a bound character. Now if I kind of hit Control A, you can see that I have this skeleton, and if I, let's say, select a joint here and I rotate it, you'll see that this character's been bound. And basically all I did from Maya is I bound it, I painted the weights, and then I exported it as an FBX and brought it inside of MotionBuilder. So once we're inside MotionBuilder, what we need to do next is we need to bring in a character asset. And you can do that by going to Window, Asset Browser, and I've actually got it open off-screen over here. And if we go over to this Characters template here, we'll see that we have this thing called the character down here. Now I can do one of two things. In this case, I'm going to be dropping it into my scene. But basically what the character template is, it has an expectation of a certain number of joints and the naming of those joints. And if you happen to follow the naming convention of this template, which we'll see in a second here, you'll actually be able to drop this right onto the root joint here. Or I should say basically the hips joint. Since we don't have that though, we're going to just drop it in the scene. And then from there, what we've got is we basically got a template that we're going to use to basically fill out all these joints. And if I go over here and I bring my character controls window in, just drag this down so we can see the whole profile. Under the definition section, you see that what we have is we have a bunch of different joints right now that are all white. And all these basically represent are the individual joints that we have in our skeleton here. So we're going to need to go ahead and begin to fill out this template. And we can do this by one of two ways. We can either select this joint, and if I right click, I can say assign selected bone, and we'll see that that joint turns green, and that means that it's something has been assigned to it. So from here, I'm just going to go and I'm going to begin to kind of add the rest of these joints just by right clicking. Now we've got a few spine joints here, so what we're going to need to do is, rather than just assign one joint, we can click this little triangle above, and it takes us to kind of a more detailed layout of what the spine is. So we can continue to go through to say assign, or the other way we can do it is if I double click the joint that we want to assign a joint to, and then just click the joint that we want to have assigned there. I'm saying joint a lot here. And then that'll actually assign it to the template. So the next one we have is the neck. And you can tell when you select this by the bottom right-hand corner of the viewport, it shows you what joint we have selected. So that one's the neck base, that one's spine 03 base. So I'm just going to go back to the full skeleton by clicking the full body. And then I'm just going to click that other triangle to look at the neck. So I can double-click the neck here. And then let's click that joint. Oops, I got to deselect everything first. If you need to deselect, you can do so by double-clicking in the actual viewport. Typically in some program like Maya or 3D Studio Max, you can just click once and deselect, but in MotionBuilder, you actually have to double-click in the viewport. So now that I've got this selected, just by double-clicking, I can click that once, and then go back out, and then we've got our head here. So I'm going to select that, double-click it, and then just click our joint. So I'm going to go ahead and move on to the leg. And one thing about areas like the legs and the arms is if you have this little icon selected here up at the top, it's actually going to do mirror matching. So you'll see when I select one leg, it's automatically going to know that the other leg is in that same spot but on the other side, and it'll fill that out respectively. So if I just double click this, click on my femur, and kind of go down to my shin, my ankle, and then here. Now you got to be careful here because this is kind of, it's got flipped a bit. So I've got to make sure I select my left toe. And that's good there. Go back up. You'll see that I have both legs selected, or both legs assigned. So I'm going to click my reference now. I'm going to go ahead and do my arms. I'm going to click the left shoulder. So I want to make sure we get this left shoulder here, which I have named clavicle. And then just kind of work my way down the humerus, forearm, and wrist. Now, don't worry about the yellow for now. I'll explain that in a second. What these joints are here is this basically the base template that you have to use in order to kind of get moving. So you don't really need to have fingers or toes or any additional joints here. Now, of course, when we look at the spine, we could have just a number of spine joints here, but the ones that we see here in this template outline right here are the base joints required. Now, when we actually take this down to a control rig and begin to drive it with motion capture, if we wanted to begin to use other assets or other areas like your fingers, we would have to go into here and actually select all these fingers and essentially do what we did for the remainder of the joints here. So I'm just going to go ahead and do that real quick just by double clicking. You know what, I'm actually messing this up a bit, so I'm just going to hit clear on these because it was the left hand that we needed to do and I was choosing the right hand. So just going to clear these out real quick. Okay, so this is the left hand. Go ahead and select my left joints. Oops. Clear that just in case. Now this is the point in the process where it actually becomes nice if you've got a template set up. So if I actually were to go into the Navigator window, which you can get to through Window, where's it at? We got Add Navigator here, and I've actually got it open already. If I were to go over to my characters that I have here, you'll see that under Character Definition, under the Base Required, it has a bunch of joints already here. So if I were to have my root named Hips, and my left femur named Left Up Leg, and my left knee named Left Leg, what would happen is I would actually be able to go and drop that template on the actual hips of the character and would automatically fill in all these spots where the name is the exact same. So that's when it's actually pretty helpful to have a naming convention that fits the template inside MotionBuilder, but as we can see here, it's not necessarily required. So just gonna go through here, get these last few. Okay, now we can back out here. Now one thing that we notice here is we've got this little triangle here, and that basically means that, you know, the validation status of this rig is not quite ready yet. When it was a red square, it means that we didn't have anything filled out, or it was completely not ready. But this yellow little triangle here indicates that there's still something wrong, and usually when you hover over it, it's going to tell you what's wrong, and it says, you know, the right and left arm don't seem to be parallel to the x-axis. So inside MotionBuilder and motion capture in general, when you're characterizing a character or doing a range of motion on a motion capture stage, they usually typically start and end in this pose, which is called a T-pose. And the reason why is because it basically creates a good base for your character to line up to when it starts to match that data. So what we're going to have to do from here is just kind of go in and line up these joints so that they fit. And I'm just going to go set mine to local real quick. Free to do that. I'm going to hit Control F to go into the front view. Just kind of zoom in on this right here. So it looks pretty close, but we're still not gridding a green yet, so let's go ahead and look in our top view by hitting Control T. Okay, that looks fairly good. And it might be because we've also got these other joints on the arms that aren't quite aligned yet. So I'm just going to select those and start to reorient them as well. Okay, and as we can see, is once we straighten out these arms to make them completely straight like this template here, we now have the green circle here which indicates we can go ahead and characterize it. So I'm going to hit Control E to go back to my perspective view or my producer perspective or schematic view. And then what we can do from here is we can just kind of continue to go in these various views and just line up the rig as best as possible. Again, it doesn't have to be perfect. There's going to be some cleanup involved usually in just about any take that you do from motion capture to an actual character like this, but it's good to get it as close as possible. Okay, and then the last thing that we have to do is we can go over to the Navigator window, or we can do it through the Character Controls window by clicking this button right here. But if we click the Characterize checkbox, it's going to say character must be in stance pose facing the positive z-axis, which it is. And then just choose whether it's a biped or quadruped. And then we were all set. We have a characterized character that can now be used to, let's say, drive another character or be driven by, let's say, motion capture data. All right, well, that completes this week's tips and tricks video. Thanks again for watching 3dmotive.com.